Do you want to make pixel art sprites like this, but you can't really draw? If you have basic Blender skills, I can show you how. We're gonna cheat a little bit, but at least we are not using AI. I'm the creator of the pixel art rendering addon that's available on Gumroad. Huge thanks to everyone that downloaded and donated. There are so many of you. So many, in fact, that I got overwhelmed by the attention and disappeared from the internet for about 3 years. But I'm back, and with a much better tutorial this time. Today we're going to give our boy Tatsugiri the sprite it deserves. I mean, come on, what's that? One grain of rice? We can do better than that. I'm gonna start by modeling the basic shapes. I'm not the best at modeling, but that's okay, really. It doesn't have to be perfect, since the low resolution will hide most of the flaws. Just remember to keep it simple. We can't use textures with the pixel rendering, sadly, so that's one more reason to keep it very simple. It is a good idea to apply the pixel addon as soon as possible, so we can see how our model is going to look like. Download the addon from Gumroad, leave a big tip, and save the script somewhere. In Blender, go to Preferences, then the Addons tab, click Install from Disk, and select the script you downloaded. You can access the addon panel by clicking N in the viewport. By clicking the first two buttons in the addon panel, we first set up our scene and then create the pixel art material. Now if I apply the material to my object and I click render, it will already be in pixel art style. To change the colors, I open the shader editor and mess with this color ramp. I am going to borrow a palette from a popular video game series that I will not name and that will definitely not get me sued. It is important to add the colors in order of value, from darkest to lightest. You can also change the number of colors. This technique does not work in real time, so let's hit render again and see how it looks. Now I can adjust the light so I can see all the colors that we picked. The amount of dithering between colors can be adjusted in the soft light node. Enough about shaders, let's talk about rice. To make it, I used a noise texture to displace a subdivided cube. The eyes are just two planes, not connected to the model. Right now they are casting a weird shadow, but we can fix that. I disabled the ray visibility for shadows in the eyes object properties. To make the irises, I made one completely black and one completely white material. I put both in the same iris object and used edit mode to assign each to the right polygon. I adjusted the camera and light positions and also the output resolution. The lowest you can go with the resolution, the better. The thickness of the outline can be adjusted in the freestyle tab. I'm pretty happy with how the model is looking. I wonder what the next step is. Now that we're out of that hell, I can finally pose our friend. I made the shadow material just like the eye one, but in gray. And it's just a circular plane. The eyes were also rigged and posed. A neat trick I often do is removing the outline from a group of objects. I created a collection called No Outline and moved the shadow inside. In the View Layer menu, inside Freestyle Line Set, there is an option called Collection. I selected the No Outline collection and set it to Exclusive. Now the shadow has no outline. I then started experimenting with the animation. It took a lot of exploration to find a satisfying idle. You can see me discarding and combining a bunch of ideas here. I am animating at 24 frames per second. Lower frame rates look better with the pixel art visuals, but I have a trick about this to show you later. At some point, I added a bone for the iris and animated it too. I made sure to see the rendered version frequently to make sure the poses looked good. I made this blinking animation by creating a set of closed eyes and switching between the open and closed ones. But how did you switch the models of the eyes during the animation? Next question, please. The animation needed something more, so I made this spinning jump at the end. Now, for that trick I mentioned, go to the graph editor, select one of your curves, and hit N to open the side panel. In the modifiers tab, add stepped interpolation. I chose a step size of 3 here, but you can experiment. Now copy this modifier, select all the curves in your animation, and paste the modifier. The animation is now in a much lower frame rate, and this is non-destructive. It is now finally time to export. With an output folder selected, I set the file format to PNG and hit render animation. The resolution is still very small, but we will deal with that in a moment. I will show you an extra step that you can do to add smear frames to your animation and other VFX. If you want, you can just skip this part. I use A sprite, it is great. Here I can open the first frame of my animation and set the duration to 41.6 milliseconds to match our 24 frames per second in Blender. I used the draw tools to clean up some of the frames, then I made these mirror lines. Yes, they are just lines drawn on top of the sprite. You might have seen my stereo animation, and a lot of people were very curious about this mirror there. It was made in this exact same way. To export, I click Save As and select PNG. Now I can overwrite the frames that Blender outputted with the new ones that I did on a sprite. Now back to Blender. To make the final render, I used Blender's video editing module. Here I load all the frames as an image strip, and they get automatically scaled up. To maintain the crisp pixels, I set the transform filter to nearest. Now I adjust the resolution and the frame range and render it as FFmpeg video. Here is our final result. Here is a bonus chapter for you freaks that want to make video games. To import our Tatsugiri into Unity, we need to turn our animation into a sprite sheet. I'm going to use a sprite to open animation and export as sprite sheet. Here I select Open Sprite Sheet so I can use the magic wand to delete the background. When I save this, I'll have a long image with all the frames side by side. Here is a brand new Unity project. I will drag the sprite sheet to my assets and change the texture type to sprite. Make sure to change the filter mode to point and disable compression. The sprite editor can be used to set the size of our sprite and split up the sprite sheet. Now if I drag it to the scene, a new animation is created and I can see our sprite in the world. The last step is to change the frame rate of the animation and it is done. To finish it off, here's the demonstration I made. I rendered the same animation in multiple different angles and used the camera to switch between them.